And joining us with more on the financial sector's earnings is Ed Butovsky, managing partner of 720investor.com. So Ed, thank you for joining us. So far, a solid quarter for the banking industry. We have results from Goldman up over 100%, Citi profit up 42%, JP Morgan up 31% from the same period last year. What's your takeaway from these results?
Well, first of all, thanks for having me on today, Michelle. And I think it's a really important subject because these financial stocks literally lead the S&P 500, but more importantly, the Dow stocks, because the Dow is very heavily reliant on these financial stocks. So it's very good for the overall market to see these companies hitting good numbers. And your observation is spot on that interest rates, you know, were relatively low in the first quarter. And as they've risen a little bit, that will start to slow down business because low interest rate environment is very good for these banks. There's a lot of loans that, you know, obviously take place, but there's also a lot of M&A activity where they make a bulk of their money. So as interest rates start to rise, people need to start becoming a little more aware. But that doesn't signal that the markets are going to sell off, and it doesn't mean that these stocks are not going to do well. It just means that it's going to get a little bit tougher for them the third quarter and fourth quarter if we continue to see rates rise.
But Ed, what does the strong performance in the second quarter mean for the U.S. economy overall, especially with regards to financial stocks?
Well, I don't know if it means anything other than the rise in those stocks reflect a stronger economy. So if you want to know, you know, what came first, it's really the stronger economy. And because of that, those stocks started to move a little bit higher. I mean, look, we have a much better economy than we did a year ago. There's no question about that. The question that a lot of people have in this country, as you know, Michelle, and we've talked about this, is where should it be? Is it where it needs to be right now? And a lot of people will argue that we should be doing a lot better than we are at this moment. But I'm happy. Look, I mean, my clients are doing well. I hope your 401k is doing well. But I also believe that we have to really be mindful of what's going to happen overseas, because Phil a little while ago talked about the unemployment rate in Europe and around the world. Those are things that are going to impact the stock market in the United States. If we start to see a much slower economy in Europe, it will impact the U.S. stock prices.
Well, Ed, global macroeconomic issues aside, Q2 has been good, but there are some ominous clouds on the horizon, not just what's going up in Europe, but also with regards to regulation, potential Washington regulation, an onslaught of that could put a major dent in profits, and possible rising interest rates. How much of an impact will this have on financials?
Oh, well, tremendous. I mean, the regulations, you know, every time you turn around, there's another regulation either being enacted or being proposed. And a lot of it is right on those big, bad banks, you know, and they have weathered the storm. I mean, what a group that has, you know, kind of taken everything that's been thrown at them and pushed it aside and continued to grow. That tells you the strength of our banking system. Higher interest rates don't necessarily will be a negative for these banks right away. At some point, you know, they still make those spreads. And, you know, making those spreads is a good thing for them. But, you know, we got to get this economy going or we will start to see, you know, lending slow down. The regulations, Michelle, in my mind, are the most diabolical thing that we have going on, because every time they turn around and start to get healthy, another congressman stands up or a senator and proposes a bill that's going to hit them right where it counts. And that is in terms of their earnings.
Well, you know, tomorrow the big focus is on what Fed Chairman Ben Bernanke is going to say. It's a semi-annual testimony to Congress. Investors hoping to garner further clues in the direction of monetary stimulus. Firstly, what can we expect to hear from Bernanke tomorrow? And can the banks actually survive if their big sugar rush of easy money is taken away?
Yeah, I mean, I differ with a lot of people on Wall Street, and quite frankly, I know I'm right about this. The printing of money, really impacts those treasuries that are somewhere between 15 to 30 years out. It does not impact short-term rates at all. And I don't believe the printing of money has stimulated stock prices. You see them move, but there's no dotted line directly from the printing of money to corporate earnings. So can they weather that? Absolutely. What you have to look for from Bernanke is going to literally say the same thing he's been saying over and over again. We're seeing signs of recovery, but we have to be mindful, and they're going to continue to try to print money as we go forward, maybe tapering it down the road. But Do not get too caught up with that. The CFOs and the CEOs of American businesses are doing an incredible job in light of, or in front of, all this regulation that's coming at us. And because of that, we're going to continue to see stock prices rise. Do not worry too much about Bernanke, is my point.
But Ed, I mean, seriously, with the monetary policy tightening and the free flow of easy money ending, surely that's going to affect financials.
No, it will not. It just won't, Michelle. And I'll look forward to seeing you a month or two from now, hopefully, and we can talk more about that. But I just don't see that happening right now, Michelle.
Well, Ed, I hope you're right. We'll see how that pans out. Now, with regards to last earnings season, the majority of companies beat on the top line. They beat on the bottom line. They managed to come in beating estimates.
That's right.
Because they cut down their costs and such. But revenue was low. And we're starting to see that with, example, Coca-Cola reporting some low revenue but still beating estimates. How much of a concern is that?
That's my biggest concern. You can only ask so much of these CEOs and CFOs. They can only do so much. And at some point, you're going to see earnings revisions, and we're starting to see that right now. So you're spot on again with Coca-Cola. That should be the biggest concern, because when you see those top-line revenue numbers start to fall down and not hit those expected numbers, that's when you really have to be concerned. So be concerned about that. Don't be concerned about Bernanke.
All right, we're going to have to leave it there. Some very interesting words. Ed Butofsky, managing partner of 720investor.com.